Welcome back to this special broadcast of Nine News live from Exmouth. We're getting close to totality right now, and this is why the world's eyes are on Exmouth. This graphic shows the path of totality as the eclipse grazes the northwest coast of Australia. The red line is the line of totality, and it goes right across Exmouth, the only town in the world to lay directly in the path of totality. And the start is exactly at 11:27 this morning in the northwest, and that's just minutes away right now. And this is how it'll look in Exmouth at its peak, the entire sun covered by the moon for a total of 62 seconds. The sudden darkness will have big impact, not just on us watching it, but the animal kingdom, the bird kingdom. They'll all be affected by the darkness and the sudden drop in temperature, and you can really feel it. And we've got so many experts who've been around. Rick Tonello is certainly someone from the Gravity Space Center, is in demand, and he joins us now. We're so appreciative. He's just getting his breath back because he's been looking at all of these telescopes, all of these cameras, all of these particular items we need today. Rick, so we just thank you so much for your time.
My
because
pleasure.
We've just got to the really exciting, it's about to unfold very soon. How are you feeling?
A little out of breath, but I think my time at the gym has stopped me from being a wheezing mess on the ground, so I can actually talk.
Just talk us through what we're feeling now. Now, you can see that our viewers can see on the bottom of their screens, or see on their screens, where we're at with the moon in front of the sun. Just talk us through what's happening.
So we're edging ever so closer to totality, and that's where the moon completely obscures the disk of the sun. Now, I think those live feeds might be from us, from the Gravity Discovery Center. Oh, excuse me.
That's all right. You're getting your breath back. And we can really feel this temperature as it goes down. And we can really start to see the darkness. And we're going to turn our lights off.
Yes.
In very soon, we've been told to do that. And we'll get the real effect of what this is like. You can feel the temperature, can't you?
Oh, yeah. It's really dropped substantially. And the light is just so muted. It's almost like wearing a pair of sunglasses, but not wearing a pair of sunglasses. And I can't describe it in such a way that the viewers will appreciate it, but it is just so weird and unnatural. But yeah, it's incredible. It's an incredible experience.
I'm just going to take the hat off because we don't need to keep the sun away from the face.
That's right.
And we'll flick the switch on the lights.
Yep.
I'm already surprised at how dark it's getting. I can see lights on inside cars and at the front of some cars parked.
Yep.
You've been across all of the technology that goes to recording this. You've got an enormous amount of equipment.
Yep.
It's a big day for you, isn't it?
It is a very big day for us. We're live streaming the entire event to not just within Western Australia or Australia, but all around the world. So our live signal is actually going out to the Shanghai Planetarium, to the Singapore Science Centre, and whoever else is picking up on our signal at YouTube and our Facebook page. But we had a few little hiccups at the start, but just like Apollo 13, we worked the problem, and this is our finest hour.
So we're getting very close, aren't we, to that point? Will it get much darker than this, do you think?
Yes, it will. It will get, I'll just get my eclipse glasses. They're just over there, that's perfectly fine.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you very much.
I might grab mine
Here we go.
If that's okay.
Yep.
Have a little look.
Quick look. We are really close now. In fact, the time is probably about 2 minutes to go or thereabouts, by estimates. So the whole thing will unfold at 11:29 and 24 seconds when it goes into totality. So that's when it'll get really dark. And all around, you'll see a 360-degree sunset. And that's an experience that I only saw that once during the annular solar eclipse back in 99 in Greenwich.
So why do we get that? Why do we get that effect of a 360 sun?
Well, because the shadow is circular, it's the circle of the moon, and then you still have daylight all the way around, but it's just that little patch of area, like right now. Oh my gosh, that's just gone really dark. We just get this darkness, this dark shadow.
And the silence, Rick.
Yeah, the silence here, but the silence over at the main viewing area is going to be quite loud. People are going to be clapping, cheering, crying. There'll be camera shutters firing off. There'll just be all sorts of activity going on. Oh, here we go.
Oh, yeah.
We can actually start to see some planets. So we can see Venus over there.
Oh, we can.
And then just up somewhere over there should be Jupiter. But, look how dark it is. This
it's
is,
amazing.
Whoa!
Let's do that light there. We'll just kill that light there.
Yep. There it is. That's it.
That is totality. Can that we look at it, Rick?
Yes, we can.
Can I look at it
hang
now?
On a sec. Give me 2 seconds.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
Just come around this side so we can. No, I know you're excited. No, keep looking.
Yes.
Oh, that is extraordinary.
Oh, my
look
God.
At that.
There is, looks like a prominence off the edge. That is incredible. And just up from it is Jupiter. So we can actually see planets. And if we look around, but the whole thing is, if we've got such little time, just try and take it all in, the sunset, the planets, the actual...
There's like a sparkle around,
sparkle,
can you
give me a minute?
You're a bit emotional.
Yeah. Oh my God. That is the most incredible thing I've seen. It is just absolutely stunning. I'm lost for words. That's a first. It's actually happening. Oh, there we go. It's coming back now.
You can feel it.
There we go. That's it. That's 62 seconds done. Yeah, that was over so fast. There we go. And it's coming back.
Straight, incredibly quick.
That was it.
We're starting to get light again.
Yep. That was amazing. That was absolutely incredible.
So now the moon is trying to push across to the other side.
Yes, it's moving out of the way, and now it's getting light again. And you can hear the birds. The birds are confused as hell. They're thinking, do I go to bed? Do I go stay awake? What am I doing? But indeed, that was... And now it's coming back light, and you can actually start to see a lot more light. That was over so fast. They're not kidding. So, yeah.
It was so cool, too, wasn't it?
It was.
The temperature was... It was...
Yeah.
It was... And a beautiful, warm sort of... When I say warm, within yourself, I felt emotional, too.
It was. You got this... I suppose it takes us back to, you know, just our... We seem to have lost something in the modern-day technologies that to go out there and just simply look at the night sky or look at celestial phenomena like this really stirs something deep in the human psyche. And it just puts us more back in touch with the universe in which we live. And that's why astronomers and astrophysicists do what they do, is because they want to know more, they want to keep exploring and understand more about the universe in which we live. And having experiences like a total solar eclipse helps us understand more about our local star, our sun, and what a perfect way to do it. And with the added bonus of, you know, making you feel absolutely incredible. So yeah, I didn't think I'd get emotional, but apparently I did, so there you go.
Oh, you did, absolutely, and so did I. I felt it. And as far as eclipses go, you can get fog, you can get cloud.
Oh, yes.
As eclipses go, total eclipses.
Yep.
Give us your thoughts on that.
Yes, it just happens to be wherever you are and the local weather conditions could either make or break the whole experience, you know. A friend of mine travelled to an eclipse in Africa once, and of course when he got there it was cloudy for days and he missed out. But then today we are very, very fortunate to have perfect conditions, absolutely perfect conditions. There was some cloud around yesterday that cleared off, and now it's just this typically amazing Exmouth sky that we're experiencing. It's just big, blue and warm.
Rick Tonello, thanks so much for your time.
Pleasure.
Thanks for sharing that with us. That was incredibly special, something we're never going to forget. Good luck. I know you've got lots more to do.
Yes, indeed.
Good luck with everything else, and we'll talk to you later on as well.
My pleasure, Tom. Thank you very much. All the best.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Fantastic there. Rick, thanks you. And Sherilee Biggs, she's been right in among where we've got something like over 2,000 people looking to the sky. It's about 300 metres from here. Sherry, what a remarkable experience.
Oh, Tomo, it was amazing. I didn't expect to get emotional myself, but it was just that lead up as well, that eerie silence, and then suddenly the cheering, everyone was so excited, and then again, that emotion of just waiting for that next diamond ring to come out. Now, I've got a few viewers here with me. Now, how did you find it? Was this your first eclipse?
It was, yeah, my very first one. Thanks to my dad, he really wanted us here. We drove all the way up from Perth, so yeah, and that was our first total one, and the weather absolutely perfect, and that it's like close to the middle of the sky, amazing conditions. It was incredible.
What did you think when it shadowed over
I was expecting, I thought it was going to be much darker, but it was absolutely beautiful. The colors around the horizon and everything, it was amazing. And then you could see the sun around the moon when it was I could never imagine that without actually seeing it in the first place. It was incredible.
It's just so wild. Oh, well, thank you so much. If you take a look here, Tomo, everyone is just in awe at the moment. Let's see who else we can find over here. How did you find that?
Fantastic. My first one, but I've never seen one before. Yes, always have been wanting to.
Did you find it as moving as I did?
I think I did, yes, yes. But I pretty much knew what to expect because I read up and listened to people talking about them, so it was great.
But nothing can really prepare you for being right here on the ground in Exmouth, the best spot in the, in the world to see it.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah. Would you do it again?
Yes, I would.
Yeah. I think I would as well. That was fantastic. Well, Tomo, there's just so many people here. It was literally, it was very quiet. Hey, guys, can we, will you jump on Nine News with us? How did you find that? That was just magical, wasn't it?
It was a magical one. And we've been traveling for 11,000 kilometres to see this for 1 minute.
Oh, wow. Where did you come from?
From the Netherlands.
Oh, wow.
And it's my 11th
11th eclipse.
Eclipse.
And what about, how did this one differentiate from all the other eclipses that you've seen?
It was at the sea, and that's very beautiful because you can see the light coming on. First you see the darkness coming on, and then you see the light coming on, and it's really marvelous.
And what keeps you going? What makes you travel around the world to see these eclipses?
You have seen now the one, and you're going to do it many more times.
100%. I think I definitely will. Well, welcome to Exmouth. We love having you here. Well done, guys. I'll come over here. How about you guys? How did you find it?
Well, it was really beautiful. I get a bit emotional when I see it, and I think we are all part of this and of the universe. That's really something special. And all these people, you could hear the noise going on while they were, it was echoing. Everybody was happy. Yes, it happened, and we are present.
It was a very nice one because the Bailey beads were perfect, the diamond ring was perfect. All well organised. You know, Australians can organise something.
We can do it quite well. But are you guys eclipse enthusiasts or is this your first?
No, certainly not. I think seveners or eights.
And where have you come from today?
We're also from the Netherlands.
Oh,
yes.
Wonderful. Oh, well, it's
dark
the dark side. Yeah, it's a little bit cooler there
from
at the moment, isn't it?
Yes, it is. You're right. Yes.
Oh, well, thank you so much, guys. I hope you enjoy the rest of your time in Exmouth. We'll take a look over here. Oh, hello. How are you going? Okay, well, you've got all the gear over there. How did you find that?
Awesome. Yeah, the most beautiful one I've seen so far.
Oh, really? And what made it so beautiful?
The corona, and the protuberances.
It was just
everything, the atmosphere, everything. Yeah.
It was just absolutely glorious, and exactly that. Thank you so much. The atmosphere has just been electric down here. I didn't think I would get emotional, Tomo, but I'm wiping away tears right now. So I don't even know what to say anymore.